That's a big daggone tree too. So I got some chips in my hand here from that first big one, that one you see over there, that big one over there. Best we can count with the rings the way they are in it, that tree is somewhere in the neighborhood of 90 years old. And you can see pretty easy how the tree was starting to constrict on itself and die. It was at the end of its lifespan anyway. In the last 15 years on the rings, it really constricted on itself. I'm gonna take these chips and I'm gonna put them in a little Ziploc bag, and we may do some type of giveaway with them soon. I don't know, I just think stuff like that's pretty neat. They smell like rich lighter pine. So we'll put these in a Ziploc baggie and we'll get them brought to the house, and one of y'all may have some 90-year-old pine tree salt chips from the John Deere cutter here in your mailbox soon. Okay, so we're gonna bring the 620 over here now. I gotta listen to it pull for a little bit. It's got some of these right here that was leaning really bad, and the only way to get them on the ground safely was to bridge them across this draw right here. I got 1, 2, 3, 4 more big ones, 5 more big ones over there I'm gonna be able to get off this little draw right here, and then this one little bitty. And but like y'all can see that one right there, it's got the top broke out of it. That's what most all this look like. Now if it looks like that, I'm not cutting that. But these things are leaning or busted or something. You know, you can see that one right there, it's busted. But anyway, Matt's gonna come over here and grab these, and you're gonna listen to that 620 pull them out. Y'all ain't seen that John Deere skidder drop any trees now, have you? Come on, Tiger Cat.